Okay, it looks like that's all the way down in there now. Now, if it's bound up, it won't slide really easy. You'll watch, I'll let it go and it just drops really easy. It should drop without any pressure. That's how you know that things are lined up okay and you don't have anything bound up. Now, here's the seal going in. I always like to get that a good start by hand. Just take your time. A lot of times you can just push this by hand down, but depends on the seal manufacturer. Sometimes they're extremely tight. Okay, so we got the seal in now. There should be the groove inside that you see that this little clip ring goes in. Just to check, make sure it's not binding up. Bring the fork tube up and let it go. It should be able to drop under its own weight, okay? And what we're going to do is we're going to snap this snap ring in. If I can find my screwdriver. Snap that thing in there. That's what holds the seal in there if things are to try to come apart. And I like to double check, make sure it's seated in there really good. Which it is. Okay. So now we got new fork seals. I'm going to slide the dust cover down. Just use your hands to try to pop that in place. Okay. Check it real good. Now this might put a little bit, no, it's still dropping, so we're real good still. Sometimes it won't after that, but there's your new dust cover. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to start assembling the rest of this. And you have, first of all, you have the mid-valve chamber assembly. This is what is known as the mid-valve right here. There's another piston on this. It slides inside of this mid-valve. It's got to go in, excuse me, like that. Be a little careful. Not to really force anything, should just slide right together. There's a bushing in there, you gotta be a little careful with it. If you're worried, you can always put a little Teflon around the threads of that. If you just take your time, it's usually fine. Okay, so now this is gonna go back into this fork leg. You can see there's threads on this end. That's what the base valve threads into. This base valve is going to thread right into here once you get it inside the fork. Basically slide that baby right in like so. And then we're going to take this base valve and we're going to start threading it in, trying to get it to... I might even push this down to kind of help hold it a little bit. Then you're going to go ahead and tighten that down really good. Probably turn this off to do that, and then we'll show you how to assemble the rest of it real quick. So, hold tight, folks. Okay, everybody, we're getting ready now to put the this piston rod in, spring. Okay, it's a really important part right here. There's a little needle. It's got a spring on it. This is part of the compression adjuster circuit. Okay, it has to go down inside of that center tube, followed by the push rod. The spring goes first because it pushes the push rod up on its own. So I'm going to take that, we're just going to slide that baby in and let her go down to the bottom, followed by this push rod, like that, okay? That's part of the, actually it's part of the rebound adjuster. I said compression, I meant rebound. Okay, so now we've got the spring left, we've got the top cap, we've got the spacer that goes under the top cap, and the nut. Right now, actually, what needs to be done is we need to now put fork oil in. Let's talk about that for a minute. There's different weight of fork oil. This bike before had, I'm pretty confident, I think it had the older style fork oil. I don't know what I do with it, but it's 20 weight. The manual calls for 5 weight, I believe. I'm going to use 5 weight because I know how it works, and I can always use the clickers to adjust it if it's too soft. I've also firmed up the valving a little bit on the low speed compression. So we're going to put we're going to start out with 720 cc's of oil that we're going to put inside the fork tube, and then we're going to bleed it by using this plunger and going up and down like this until all the bubbles come out. Once that's all the bubbles have come out, then we're going to measure from the top down to the fork oil level, and the manual calls for 122 millimeters. That's basically 4.8 inches. If you're having problems bottoming out with your bike, you can raise the fork oil level a little bit, maybe go down to 115 or 110. Can get pretty solid in a hurry if you go too full, and you can make it a little bit softer by going down below or going to like maybe 125 or 130 millimeters. My preference is to use the volume of oil that they recommend and change the characteristics of the suspension with the valving. But so we're going to actually, I'm going to put 125, I'm going to go 125 millimeters down from the top of this for the settings for EveRide. And then we're going to finish buttoning this baby up and get it back in the bike, and then we'll have the other fork leg to do. So we're going to go ahead and do that off the camera, and then when we get ready to start putting it back, we'll get
with you. So, EveRide, what do you think of your new cafe racer? We're thinking about mounting your bars down like that. What do you think? Anyway, we're just playing. So, okay, we're done with the forks. We have taken them completely apart. New seals, new O-rings, new valving, low speed and high speed. We used a lighter fork oil fluid. The fork oil that was in it was a 20 weight. We went to a 5 weight, and I checked it, and I think it's going to be great. I've got some initial settings. Right now I've got 12 out on the compression. I've got 10 out on the rebound, just as a starting point. And we've also replaced the head tube bearings, and it is just so nice and smooth now. There's no ratcheting, nothing. It's just really nice and smooth. So we're taking that. I think we're doing great. So we're making some progress. We still have to replace the seals in the front tire before we put that on. And we're going to clean up all this wiring the best we can before we put that stuff on. And we'll put the bars back on, and then stay tuned, because the next step is going to be, as Rojo Neck says, in this gentle area, carburation. And we're doing some trick stuff. We're not just cleaning the carburetor. We're not just taking it apart, making sure everything's okay. We're doing some tweaking and tuning on EveRide's carburetor. So stay tuned for the next episode. Front forks are ready to go. I can't wait to try this thing out. I hope EveRide's excited for it. But we're just motoring right along tonight. Oh, and EveRide, I'm not sure if you need this or not. It keeps falling off.
Oh, so sad. It's been so abused. 59 minutes flat, baby. We'll be doing 59 minutes, tore it all apart, revalved and everything.
Whee!